Now, about some brief introduction about weather forecasting. Weather forecasting has been one of the most scientifically and technologically challenging problem around the world in the last century. Weather forecasting entails predicting how the present state of the atmosphere will change. In this project, the use of data mining techniques in forecasting the weather was carried out using the Naive-Bayes algorithm on a sample data that is collected from UCI repository. Now, what is Naive-Bayes? Naive-Bayes classification algorithm is a probabilistic classifier. It is based upon the probability model that incorporates strong independent assumptions. That means it has the features of that particular instance, or you can say that the feature of the instance which is going to be predicted, all these features are independent in each other. Naive-Bayes is a simple technique for constructing classifier models that assign class label to the problem instances. That means it is basically a classifier that basically assigns or that predicts the class label for the problem instance. That is, for a particular instance, if we need to predict a class label, we will use the Naive-Bayes classifier algorithm. It assumes that the value of the particular feature is independent of the value of any other feature given the class value. For example, a fruit may be considered to be an apple if it is red in color, round in shape, and 10 cm in diameter. A Naive-Bayes classifier considers each of these features to contribute independently to the probability that this fruit is an apple. That means each and every feature is independent to each other, regardless to any other possible correlations between the color, roundness, and diameter features. Now, as the Naive-Bayes algorithm is a probabilistic classifier, it is basically based upon the Bayesian theorem. That is, the formula used for calculating the probability here is probability of H with respect to E, that is the probability of hypothesis with respect to evidence, is equals to probability of evidence with respect to hypothesis multiplied by probability of hypothesis divided by probability of evidence. Now, what is P of H? P of H is the probability of hypothesis H being true. That is, it is known as the prior probability. Now, P of E is the probability of the evidence. P of E with respect to H is the probability of the evidence given that the hypothesis is true. Probability of H with respect to E is the probability of hypothesis given that the evidence is true. Now, what is the flow chart for the whole procedure is, we will first collect the dataset from UCI repository. Then we will pre-process or filter that dataset in order to remove some kind of noise, outliers, some kind of missing values from that data set. After that, we will classify that filter data by using Naive-Bayes algorithm. Then we will analyze the performance parameters. Now, the tool used in this project is Java JDK, NetBeans IDE, and Weka as an external library. Now, I am going to demonstrate the same project into the NetBeans. What I will do is, I have created one project named Weather Forecasting here. What I will do, I will right click to the graphical user interface file, that is the main graphical user interface file, and click to the run file. It will give me one interface in which I will browse the data set. Like, I have data sets named weather. This data set is having the five attributes, that is the outlook, the temperature, the humidity, and windy. By using these five parameters, it will contribute that whether the child will go to play according to the weather condition, whether it is feasible to play outside or not. That is, yes or no. And these are some instances related to these parameters. Now, I will click to the next button. Here we have missing values filter. If we have some data missing over here, then it will replace that missing values. Then we will click to the next button in order to attain the Naive-Bayes classifier result. I will click to this button. It will give me the classification result. What it has concluded, in the whole data set, I have total 14 instances. Out of these instances, 8 instances are correctly classified, corresponds to 57% accuracy, and 6 instances are incorrectly classified. And here is one Kappa statistics. The value more close to 1 means algorithm performs better. After that, we have some kinds of error rate, that is the mean absolute error, root mean squared error, relative absolute error, and root relative error. These all are the error rates over there. Now we have some kind of detailed class accuracy, detailed accuracy by class. In this category, we have true positive rate, false positive rate, the precision, recall, left measure, ROC curve, according to the class, that is yes or no. And here is the weighted average for each and every parameter over here. Now we have a confusion matrix. All these parameter, true positive, false positive, precision, recall, this accuracy, all these are calculated from the confusion matrix. That means what this confusion matrix represents is that the sum of diagonal element, that is 7 plus 1, that is 8, corresponds to correctly classified instances. And the sum of non-diagonal elements, that is 4 plus 2, that is 6, corresponds to incorrectly classified instances. That means 7 plus 2, that is 8 or 9. That is total 9 instances in the whole data set is having the value yes. Out of those 9 instances, the algorithm has correctly classified 7 instances and 2 has incorrectly classified. Similarly, we have 5 instances having the value no. Out of those 5 instances, only 1 instance is correctly classified and 4 instances are incorrectly classified. That will correspond to 42.85% of inaccuracy and 57.14% of accuracy. Now, this is all about the weather forecasting. In the similar way, you can use any other classification algorithm also over here, like naive Bayes, some kind of decision trees, random forest, some kind of boosting technique, some kind of SVM algorithm, some kind neural network algorithm. All these are classification algorithm. According to your requirement, you can use any kind of classification algorithm over here. I hope you have learned a lot from this lecture. Thank you so much for listening.